and illuminated by the Christmas decoration, a head swung into its field of vision.
You know how Cook County has tunnels?
Yeah.
The tunnels can be the digestive tract.
The physical is the forms, right? The buildings, the concrete, the bricks. What does the space make people feel? Where are the emotions?
I believe just because we're in the city, they don't want it to be a sort of people's eyes, so they put a wall there instead.
Freedom, justice, equality, and then the exit is the money. It's spitting out the money machine.
Tile flies off, sound goes here. Okay. Something like that that helps us know what goes where.
Yes, I'm directly placed in front of the door. I've been pulled up and sharpened once before. I've been fought on and covered in blood.
I won't waste my time putting my eyes through that dialogue. Even though I'm on top, I feel like I'm on the bottom today.
Bottoms. Don't feel like that. Just look down on me like everybody else does.
We're super excited to have this opportunity to share the work with all of you.
Let this thought collide with your beliefs. My name is 2017-25165, and I have 226 bones in my body, same as you.
I gave up on life for a minute. I gave up on life, and honestly, being able to go do some art really gave me an idea that I want to live, you know, and breathe.
I want you to take some deep breaths. Do you need a partner? Who needs a partner? Okay, eye contact. So I want you to try to do this in silence, and I want you to imagine that there's a couple of strings connecting from your eyes to their eyes.
Big personalness, like the closer I got, the more I felt it was a mirror that I was looking at myself.
Mm. You just hijacked my words.
I want you to imagine you got hydraulics in your knees. You're bouncy.
My hydraulic rusty.
And then one, two. Oh, I see what you were saying. I can't. Add, subtraction, addition.
Make the necessary pauses, like if there's a comma.
Yes, you're working on those. Okay.
Pero sí alguna especie de fin, una razón, sí, me gustó.
Sí, es verdad, todo bien. ¿Tienes buena voz?
No.
No, sí, de verdad, es como algo como el cuerpo de la tierra, algo así. Yeah, puedes escuchar tu voz ahorita. Okay. So, lo hiciste como tres veces, ¿verdad? This is not about perfection. There's no such thing. But it's rather about experimentation.
I'm sorry, but I can't die today. It's just not possible.
I'm sorry, but I can't die today. It's just not possible.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I've not yet built a Lego tower that reaches the ceiling. I'm sorry, but I can't die today.
I remember that concern always being like safety. And so I wanted to just kind of clarify those things today and make sure we're on the same page.
For the individuals who are doing the audio, is a picture of them doing the audio, or are you just going to hear the audio and see the art?
Yes, just hear the audio. Okay. So some of them are more emotionally driven. Some of them use humor. Part of what we're trying to do, and I think what we try to do for all these different projects, is to really inform and educate the public about the real complexities of people's lives.
While someone's memoir is powerful and it's important, I just don't want it to be like a bashing of Cook County Jail.
There were things about the entire institution, about criminal justice, that sure, they had issues with, but it didn't necessarily call out the sheriff or anybody.
I just want to look at like security, how things are going to flow on the day of, just to make sure that it goes off safely, that we've checked all the boxes to make sure that we're in compliance with all the Chicago rules.
We want to use 4 projectors. And use, if you look at the back side, 10, 9, 8.
We're editing. We work with sound engineer to make the sound.
Oh, that's what I'm excited about.
Hey, move, where you go?
I've been asking the subtle urge to purge and expound on 96. The chill's brisk, speech with the lisp because my front tooth's chipped. But I must bring you out of your comfort zone as I brought me to this microphone with literature off the dome. I feel heavenly at home in the land of 96 acres. I sought myself and found my savior. I savored that flavor that now and later cut.
Wow.
This is WLPN LP Chicago, 105.5 FM.
You're listening to Radioactive.
I want a soul. I hear people say, I am tired all the time. I see people do everything.
In my family, our roots run really deep. Our history is a long one.
The one thing that is for certain is that I have definitely seen it all. Do you see me, or do you just look past my pain?
Solid. That's why all of my friends' tiles are breaking off, leaving slowly, every day, because you're our cheesy and weak mistress. Floor, if this room can talk, Mr. Tiles, you would be made out of a lion.
So the sound effects are going to be
goop, 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 nom, nom, nom.
No, no, help. The end.
I'm the director of Yolo Cali Arts Reach. We are the teen and youth program of the National Museum of Mexican Art. We give free art programs to teens and young adults, mainly in the Pilsen and Little Village area.
Are
when we got this opportunity from 96 Acres, it was a really great way to get them involved in a project that's outside and doing something a little bit more different than what they're kind of used to. We are power washing phrases that the young people chose to put alongside the Cook County Jail. So it's an act of clean graffiti or reverse graffiti. So instead of applying paint to a surface, you're cleaning the surface. We're being overly ambitious and gonna try to do along the whole jail. We just wanna make an impression.
I run a sports-based youth and community development organization called Beyond the Ball. We work with young people and their families through sport and play. We do a lot of community cleanups and reclaiming public play spaces, and this is a natural thing for us to want to be involved in a positive thing like this.
Because Maria and some other people from 96 Acres came by to talk to them, so I think that helped them generate the phrases. These were the ones that the Cook County Board selected. I'm more on the today is your day one, or what's your role. I really like that one because it kind of plays more with what does it mean to have a jail in the community and what does it mean to see the jail throughout the neighborhood.
I think it's getting people to think about it like the jail's here, it's my backyard, but like doing this is like, you know, it's starting to get your thoughts like, yo, yeah, why do we have a jail like right here and in this community and like that makes so much money has something like this here, you know, and we don't have a museum.
We use the pressure washer in the neighborhood usually to remove graffiti. And this is interesting because this is like reverse graffiti. So I really love this idea to use it to put a positive message just by cleaning.
Seeing like, oh, today's your day, it might just change your thought on something that just happened or something like an argument you might have had with a loved one in there.
Well, I mean, when you look at the jail, you see people, but you don't see them as a person. You see them as someone that did something bad, someone that just bad society and deserve to be the place they are. But sometimes things that people don't really do bad things to be in there, you know?
Well, yeah, I have family that's incarcerated, you know? When my cousins were here, I would visit them almost every other week. It sucks, you can't really talk to him. You're talking through a little hole and like everybody's talking so loud and you can't really say too much to him, you know? All you can say is keep your head up.
I think living in Little Village, the jail's a constant reminder of the struggles of not only our community, but other communities all around Chicago, around the country, around the world, really, that live in poverty. And it's perplexing, you know, because there's two sides to every story. And I think a project like this, it helps people get to see, you know, both sides. All the families that are broken up and the people who come to visit, you're constantly reminded. I think when you don't live by a jail, you don't usually think about, you know, people who are incarcerated or their families. It really brings that human aspect to the complexity of mass incarceration.
My first time traveling over here, I was amazed at how large the facility was. You know you've done me wrong, and you're
gonna be sorry. The physical presence of the jail is kind of just something that, like, to witness as someone who lives in the city.
Looking at the exterior wall, that's a huge gray wall. Then you've got the barbed wire behind us. And I was talking to someone earlier and I said, you know, it reminds me obviously of a border.
PARC, a large-scale data visualization, public art, and radio broadcast event occupied a half mile of public street parking adjacent to Chicago's Cook County Jail. The event featured a Vocalo, Chicago Public Media 90.7, broadcast of B.B. King's 1970 performance live in Cook County Jail through the stereos of over 100 crowdsourced cars color-coded to visualize the racial statistics of today's inmate population there. Residents and participants got together to dialogue around issues related to incarceration and its social and political impact.
The root of the project was,
what else can we do here to think about
creating a sense of community and also a community that isn't at each other's throats.
You know, we tend to believe that data is a sort of relatively neutral, simply kind of quantitative endeavor, when in fact data can be a very, very active. There's no such thing as a white and a brown and a black. What we're really talking about is shades. The audio component of the project was also a way in which to use history and use narrative also as a kind of broadcast tool.
You know, you just see a black car after black car after black car. It's stark, but not surprising.
Just being that I have a white car, I thought it would be something cool to be a part of.
Apparently we had too many white cars, so your car couldn't be part of the event, so what do you think about that?
I think it's messed up, really. I'm not sure how else to say it. Too often we think about people as numbers, and sometimes it's just a little more striking to see it visually.
I mean, I think all of us value the importance and the significance of this project in attempting to change the look into one that is much more inspiring than it currently is.
¿Cuánto tiempo
lleva
viviendo aquí en Chicago?
6 años. Y pues sí me gusta esos eventos que hacen porque pues también la gente les llama la atención y llega a ver qué es lo que está pasando en esos eventos.
I remember when B.B. King performed at Cook County Jail. I was fairly young. I must have been 13 years old. I recall being at a park nearby in the neighborhood where we were playing basketball and thinking about the concert and thinking about who was around B.B. King and how they were feeling and how their families were reacting and responding to a blues artist taking time to visit those in jail.
Exhibits like this help the public to better understand that the jail is not all about confining people behind the walls, but also giving them the tools that they need to make sure that they'll be successful when they're released back into the community.
Art is important in all aspects of our society. It's energy and creativity and innovation, and those aren't words that are usually associated with 26th and California. People who are concerned about race and poverty, the fact that our jails are not just here but across the country are filled with black and brown poor people, have come together to say we've got to look at criminal justice differently.
I live right here, right in front of the jail. Because of the jail, they don't permit us to close the streets or have any type of celebrations. We're gonna have a small mini black party. Because of this, it's the first time they've ever had a black party. They've never been able to do anything here.
My name is Bobby Wodurski. I'm a writer, performer, an organizer, and I'm here today as one of the lead facilitators on what's called Visibility Project, which is a collaboration with 96 Acres to do site-responsive art projects interrogating the narrative of Cook County Jail. I work in the education department at the Goodman Theater. We were collaborating with a group of women called the Visible Voices Ensemble, which is a group of previously incarcerated women who do performance and advocacy for folks that are transitioning from incarceration, particularly women and mothers.
I actually am one of the individuals who just recently got out of Cook County Department of Corrections, and I'm here to support the families of people that are behind there. I'm a first-hand experience that we merely made a mistake, that we aren't mistakes, and that we do deserve a second chance. And with programs like Visible Voices, with 96 Acres, we're able to get those second chances.
We're going to model an image theater for you. Anybody ever heard of image theater before? Some folks have. It's about transformation, really, of the world, but what does that look like initially in our bodies and as a collective of folks? So we will begin together by building a sculpture of fear.
Yes!
They were very interested in what it meant to do physical sculpture work with their bodies, rooted in the traditions of a couple of different people, Augusto Boal's Theater of the Oppressed, and in Guillermo Gomez Pena's Exercises for Rebel Artists. A lot of the Visible Voices women are transitioning, and they're in their first 60 days of transitioning out, some from rather long time.
I did 13 years of incarceration, so we rooting for them on the outside because everybody needs somebody.
When we're behind those walls, we feel like that our voices don't matter and what we have to say doesn't matter. And so Visible Voices, when presented to me, was a wonderful idea, a way to have an outreach to our community, to our families, to our friends, and to just anybody who just doesn't understand what all this is about.
But the idea with the kites was that if people who were out in certain portions of the jail could be able to look up and see that, we're able to get messaging inside that this was happening so that people knew that there was support out here.
My name is Josue Aldana. I'm here to support the efforts of the 96-acre project, along with Maria Gaspar. Déjame volar, let me fly. Déjame vivir, let me live. Soy, I am. Déjame soñar, let me dream, y sentir, and feel. Vivan, vive mis niños. Vuelen, y vuelen lejos. I live, my children, but fly. Fly far away. Go where your mind takes you. And libertad. Libertad. No más. No más a la violencia, no más a las injusticias, like no more to the injustices. They hope, you know, we connect the message of these kites.
As somebody outside of this prison wall is standing on these grounds and letting the people know that we are important too, and that we don't have to live up to that stereotype that all people are bad just because they've been inside those jail walls.
I think we wanted to engage everyone by being out here today. Talked with a lot of families today that were going in to visit family members. We were set up right by the visitor entrance here, purposely.
Lions for eyes. What about hippo?
What does it really mean to shift narrative? You know, what is the narrative, and then what are we shifting it to? I am always seeking joy in the activism. I think about my own memories as a child and the things that shape the way that I see the world. For a child, drawing a message of love and solidarity and shared humanity on a kite to somebody on the other side of that wall, I think about how that shifts the perception that child may have of incarcerated folks forever.
Can you try it for me?
Yes. Here you go.
Thank you.
If there is a tipping point for us as humans where we are drawn towards certain things, the hope is that something like this could draw us towards that tipping point. We as a community are actively building the type of world we want to live in, and that's what we had here today. And that's, I think, what I'll leave with and what was most powerful for me.